Hello, my dear students. I hope you're doing well and staying safe at your homes. And meanwhile, we make sure that you do not face any kind of resistance to your studies. Now, I am Shruti Dubey, your English teacher for class 5. And in the series of teaching you literature, I have come with one of the chapters from your textbook. Three chapters have already been taught to you. Chapter number 1, which was a poem, namely Day by Day. Then chapter number 2, The Surprising Buns. And then there was a chapter number 3, Post Haste. These all three chapters have already been taught to you. And I believe you have watched all the videos related to these chapters. Now, I am going to teach you chapter number 4, which is a poem, namely The Plaint of the Camel. Let me just give you a brief about this poem, that it has been composed by an American poet or famous author, Charles Edward Carroll. Yes, and guess what? He is famously known for his writing on these stories, basically made for children or on fantasy world. Yeah, he is very, very famous for all of such things. He is a very renowned poet. Now, I think I have already told you enough. But, you know, I just want to ask you a few questions before starting this chapter. Have you ever been to deserts? If you belong to Rajasthan, then you must have visited such kind of places, right? Okay, so to those who have been to deserts, have you ever ride a camel? I mean, have you ever enjoyed a camel ride? I don't know how many of you have done, but if not, then I am today going to introduce you to a camel who is constantly complaining about something that he possesses. And any guesses what it is? Let's see and discover it with the help of this poem. Now children, this message I think you have already received from our side. This is a link where you need to click on. This will redirect you to a page where you will get the collection of every material, every study related material which we are sending you on daily basis. This is your English course book for class 5. Contents, 3 chapters you've done, Day by Day, The Surprising Buns and Post Haste. Now we're going to study chapter number 4, The Plaint of the Camel. Okay, first I'll recite the poem and then I expect you to repeat after me. Canary birds feed on sugar and seed. Parrots have crackers to crunch. And as for the poodles, they tell me the noodles have chickens and cream for their lunch. But there's never a question about my digestion. Anything does for me. Canary birds feed on sugar and seed. First, let me tell you what canary birds are. So, canary birds are basically birds which are mostly found in European countries. So, probably most of you have not seen this kind of bird. But here I have come with a picture. So, see, this is a canary bird. As you can see, it is slightly yellowish. So, it means it is yellow in color. And this is mainly or mostly found in European countries. But let me tell you, there is one more variety of such kind of birds. They are sometimes reddish also. But mostly they are found in yellow color. Okay. So, these kind of birds, they feed on, they eat sugar and seed. Parrots have crackers to crunch. Now, crackers to crunch means they eat something crunchy. And here I have again come with a picture. See, this parrot is actually eating a crunchy biscuit. So, they love to eat crunchy things. And as for the poodles, they tell me the noodles. Poodles is a dog breed which is found in Germany. So, you must not have seen in India such kind of dog. I'm damn sure about it. But a kind of toy based whose structure is similar to this kind of toy, to this kind of dog, is basically sold in our country. So, you've seen such kind of toys, right? So, this is actually the replica or the carbon copy of such kind of dogs. So, they are actually poodles. So, they love eating noodles. They love having chickens and cream for their lunch. So, basically,
canary birds, they eat sugar and seed. Parrots have crackers. Poodles love to eat noodles, chickens and cream. But there's never a question about my digestion. So here the camel starts complaining that every kind of animal, as you can see, has something specific to eat. But when it comes to my food, when it comes to my diet, there is no specific thing. I mean, there's no specific thing that you say, okay, it belongs to camel. This is basically eaten by camel. So nobody actually bothers about what he likes. So that's what it is saying about my digestion. Means nobody really cares what I love to eat. Anything does for me. Means anything, whatever I am given, I just eat it. So everything suits me. That's what other people think about it. So in this first stanza, the camel compares itself with canary birds, parrots and poodles as to what all are given for eating. And it says because it can digest anything, no particular diet is followed for him. Cats, you're aware, can repose in a chair. Chickens can roost upon rails. Puppies are able to sleep in a stable. And oysters can slumber in pails. But no one supposes a poor camel dozes. Any place does for me. Now here, cats, you're aware, can repose in a chair. Now again, the camel complaints says basically that cats, as everybody knows, they find themselves very comfortable sitting in a chair. Repose means, you know, sit in a chair, keep in a chair in such a way that you find yourself in a very comfortable position. So cats find themselves very comfortable sitting in a chair. Chickens can roost upon rails. Roost means basically rest, or again it means to sit somewhere. So chickens, have you seen any chicken sitting upon any kind of rail? If not, here's the picture. See, these are rails. So these are chickens which are sitting on the rails. So chickens, they can roost, means they can rest upon rails. Puppies are able to sleep in a stable. Means puppies, they find themselves comfortable sleeping in a stable. And oysters can slumber in pails. Oysters, you know that they're mainly found, I show you the picture. They are oysters, you know them very well. They are found near oceans or in shallow waters also, you can find them. So they can slumber. Slumber means sleep. So oysters can sleep in pails. Their outer structure is called pail. Inside them they sleep. So and oysters can sleep in pails, but no one supposes a poor camel dozes. Dozes means to sleep. So nobody even bothers, nobody thinks a place which only and only belongs to camel, like they had, like cats, they have their special places. They have a special place where they want to sleep, or they like to sleep. Chickens, they feel good when they rest upon rails. Puppies find themselves in a comfortable position in a stable. Oysters love to sleep in pails. But for a camel, there's no specific place. Again, any place does for me. So he finds, again, any place is given to him to sleep. There's no specific place. So in this stanza, again, the camel complains about its sleeping place. It compares itself with cats, chickens, puppies, oysters, which have their particular places to sleep. But for camel, any place is just okay. Lambs are enclosed where it's never exposed. Coops are constructed for hens. Kittens are treated to houses well heated. And pigs are protected by pens. But a camel comes handy wherever sandy. Anywhere does for me. Again, lambs are enclosed where? So lamb is the baby of a sheep. So they are enclosed means confined. They are made to live in a place which is surrounded or which is covered from all four sides. So lambs are placed in an enclosed area where it is never exposed. Exposed means they never come in the sight of others. So in this way, they are made to be in a certain place. So lambs are made to live in an enclosed area, in a place which is covered, which is surrounded, which is from all four sides. coops are constructed for hens. So it means coop is the name of the house of hens. Kittens are treated to houses well heated. You know kittens, baby of cats. So kitten, they find, you may have seen people keeping kittens as their pets. So they basically live in houses also, where even, in fact, we live. So they live with us, they find themselves comfortable living with us also in our houses. And pigs are protected by pens. Means pens is a place where pigs live in. But a camel comes handy wherever it's a sandy. Means, again, when it comes to camel's house, there is no specific place. Wherever sand is there, wherever it finds sand, it lives there. It becomes very easy for him. Anywhere does for me. Again, he complains that there's no specific place which has been given to me like other animals. So, in this stanza, it complains about the dwelling place, means where they live. It compares itself with lambs, coops, kittens and pigs, all of which have their particular places to live, but it has only sand as a dwelling place. People would laugh if you rode a giraffe or mounted the back of an ox. It's nobody's habit to ride on a rabbit or to try to bestraddle a fox. But as for a camel, he is ridden by families. Any load does for me. Here again, the camel complains that people would laugh if you rode a giraffe. I ask you, have you seen any person doing or taking ride of a giraffe? No, right? Because nobody actually sits on the back of a giraffe. Nobody does that. So even if somebody does, people would laugh at that person. Or mounted the back of an ox. Nobody, in fact, you would have seen sitting on the back of an ox or cow or any, you know, and such kind of animal. It's nobody's habit to ride on a rabbit. In fact, you would find nobody sitting on the back of a rabbit. Means nobody does all of this. Nobody takes the ride of such kind of animals or try to bestraddle. Bestraddle means, you know, the way you sit on a bike also, keeping your legs on either side of it. So that's what it means here. Or try to bestraddle a fox. Nobody would you see taking the ride or sitting on a fox. But as for a camel, he is ridden by families. I mean, not even a single person takes ride of such kind of animals. But when it comes to camel, he is ridden by families. Means a number of people sits on its back. On camel's back. Families means so many people, number of people sit on my back. Any load does for me means I am comfortable with any load. Nobody even cares what I feel like when numbers of people sit on my back. So in this stanza, it complains about how people use it as a beast of burden. Any amount of weight can be heaped on its back, or any amount of people can ride on it, but nobody rides on giraffe or ox, rabbit or fox. A snake is as round as a hole in the ground, and weasels are wavy and sleek, and no alligator could ever be straighter than lizards that live in a creek. But a camel's all lumpy and bumpy and humpy. Any shape does for me. Again, he complains that, as you've seen, a snake is as round as a hole in the ground. You know the shape of a snake? It's kind of, it's a bit cylindrical. Like, it's lengthy and then, it's a bit round also in the shape. So, the snake finds itself round and it can adjust itself in a hole because its shape permits it. And weasels are wavy and sleek. Weasel, again, it's a kind of mammal whose picture I want to show you. See, now let's see first what it tells about it. Weasels are wavy and sleek. Sleek means very smooth, and wavy, I show you. This is called wavy structure, you know, zigzag, not a straight line. So actually it looks very cute, but let me tell you, it is a very dangerous animal, huh? It eats cats, mice, rabbits. So it is very dangerous, huh? And weasels are wavy and sleek. So they all have their fixed shapes. And no alligator could ever be straighter than lizards that live in a creek. Creek means rivulet or pond, you know, something like that. No alligator, you know alligator and you know lizards also. So alligator could not be made upright as compared to lizards. I mean, they cannot be, their shape cannot be changed. They are as they are. But a camel's all lumpy and bumpy and humpy. Means, now I show you what this sentence means. Lumpy, bumpy and humpy. Lumpy means very, you know, a kind spongy type. You know, you can press it from anywhere. Humpy, this structure is actually humpy. Means it is slightly heighted at the center. And bumpy means, see, lumpy, bumpy and humpy. So that's what I just show you. It's a kind of bumpy also, having a very rough surface, like wherever it finds some kind of height, then down, then again goes to some height, then down. So it is bumpy. So a camel, there is no fixed shape of camel. That's what camel is complaining, that I do not have any kind of fixed shape as a snake has, as weasels have, as alligator has, as lizards have. Any shape does for me. Like, no any shape has been described for camel. So in this last stanza, it complains about its features. It says that it is all made of bumps, humps, whereas the others like snake, weasels, alligator and lizards have sleek features, have fixed feature that can be used to define them. Yes.
Lots of complaint, right? This camel has really made. So basically what we studied in this poem, that there's a camel who is actually complaining about everything that he possesses, that he has, whether it is its diet. It says that it doesn't have any fixed diet. Whether it is its living place, again it complains that I do not have any specific living place. Whether it is, its shape, I do not have any specific shape like other animals. So this camel has a lot of complaints, but I want to tell this animal that there is one fixed name which we actually give. Do you know what it is? If you don't, let me tell you. Sheep of the desert, right? A camel is called sheep of the desert because it helps us move from one place to another on a place like sandy desert. So this, I think, we want to tell from our side to this camel. But this camel is a very cry animal, let me tell you, okay? Now, I think it's time to test your knowledge. So let's start.
Answer these questions with reference to the context. Now, as you are in 5th standard and you've done this earlier also, these lines have been taken from the poem that we just studied. And these are the questions which are based on these lines. But there's never a question about my digestion. Anything does for me. Okay. Who is my in these lines? So as you know, in the whole poem, who is actually only and only complaining? It is camel. So the camel is complaining in this poem. So who is my in these lines? So my in these lines is camel. Next. What is it lamenting in these lines? Lamenting means expressing sorrow. So what the camel is lamenting in these lines? It says it is lamenting about the variety and quality of food which other birds, animals eat or are given, while no one cares about the digestion of camels, their diet, and that no one does anything special for camels. That's what it is lamenting in these lines. Who is it comparing itself with in terms of digestion? You know now, what are the animals that he compared itself with? So it is comparing itself with canary birds, parrots and poodles. Next. But a camel comes handy wherever it's sandy. Anywhere does for me. Again, these lines have been taken from the poem. And there, here again, three questions are there. What is a camel complaining about in these lines? So the camel is complaining about its living condition. It says while other animals have a special homes constructed for them according to their comfort, it is only sand deserts for the camel. No one cares about where it lives. Which animals is he drawing a comparison with? he is drawing a comparison with animals such as lambs, pigs and kittens. Yeah, right. What do you think would be bothering a camel in sandy desert? The extreme climatic conditions in sandy desert would be bothering camels. You know, the temperature of desert area is very hot. Fill in the blanks with correct words from the boxes. Okay, some options are given. We will choose the correct one. Canary birds feed on, what do they eat? Seed and sugar. So you will write seed, sugar. Cats on a chair. Repose. Cats repose on a chair. Sit on a chair. Slumber in pails. Who does this activity? Oysters. Oysters slumber in pails. Are constructed for hens. What is the home of for hens? Home for hens is coops. Coops are constructed for hens. Kittens are kept in well heated houses. People do not ride on the back of an ox or a rabbit or a fox, but they mount on the back of a camel. I think that is enough for today. I think this is enough for today. So today we learned that poem, a beautiful poem. Then we did fill in the blanks also. We did some reference to context also. And I literally believe it is enough for today. So I'll again come in another video with another video where I'll cover the rest of the exercises, which right now I'm not able to cover. And in the next video, I'll make you write question answers, hard words, word meanings, everything which is now left. Okay. So till then, take care and till study. And today's your work, you have to recite the poem. Obviously, poem recitation is very important. And whatever you've done, you have to revise all over again, okay? So I think that's enough, okay? Bye and take care. See you again.